just tell us everything about our whole report and all the information in it.
The purpose of this project is to inform people about the quality of the Maumee River.
Our hypothesis, we thought that there would be lower pH and Q values than in 2014 in the water would be polluted.
Here's our research. The Maumee River watershed is the largest watershed in the Great Lakes region, and the watershed is over 8,000 square miles big. The Maumee River is also 136 miles long, and it spans three different states. The Maumee River flows into Lake Erie, and the river supplies 5% of all the river that flows into Lake Erie. The watershed's greatest pollution stress is due to urbanization.
If our water was to get polluted, we will have difficulty cleaning it up. Toledo has experienced algal blooms that has cost $82 million to try and clean it up.
Harmful algal blooms are living things, the environment, and the economy. Harmful algal blooms can produce toxins that can harm/kill people and animals, create dead zones, raise water treatment costs for communities, and hurt industries that depend on fresh water.
This is the best quality levels for most aquatic freshwater life. The pH was 6.5 to an 8.0. The dissolved oxygen was 7 to 11 milligrams per liter. The nitrates was 1 milligram per liter or less, and the phosphates was under 10 milligrams per liter.
And these are some of the pictures that we got for Northeast Arc. These were our main testing locations. One of them was under the high-level bridge. We tested when it was still under construction. And we tested at the DeSalle Bridge near the Hollywood Casino, near that area. We also tested near this railway bridge. It is one of the busiest railway bridges in the country. And we also tested by the grain elevators as well. And in 2015, we tested at Proud Day Park as well, but not in 2014.
This is the methods and materials. Station 1, we obtained water samples from the side of the boat for testing in VOD5 bottle prep. Station 2, we collected data, turbidity, and sunginess. Station 3 was water tests with kits and veneer probes. Tests for temperature, dissolved oxygen, pH, nitrates, phosphates, and conductivity levels. At Station 4 was water observations like latitude, longitude, atmospheric data, record visual observations regarding biotic and abiotic factors of the surrounding environment.
And this is our slide that we got data on. We see we tested for both years at the locations except for the property park, since we only tested in 2015. And also here is a graph showing the values for this stuff. Overall, the Q values were high for most tests. Q values were higher in 2015 than in 2014, showing an increase in the water quality. Q values for nitrates were extremely high in 2014 and 2015. It was the highest data we got. Q values for Seki death were extremely low for 2014 and 2015. Data for the grain elevator area, what for both years, were generally higher than anywhere else. Crown Day Park was tested in 2015 and not 2014.
Conclusion. We have concluded that the water quality of the Maumee River is very good. Before we went on the Embry Sandpiper, our hypothesis were that the pH levels in the water would be slightly lower than a normal pH level and that the water would be polluted. Our hypothesis were both proven true.
were to continue on this project, we'd most likely test even more various sites upriver and downriver in the Toledo metro area. And these are our works cited: Lake Erie Waterkeeper, EPA, the Friends of Sligo Creek, and another EPA site. And this is everything.